Let's talk about a few of the errors that Ahmed Deedat makes in some of his tapes. Let's hear what Deedat himself has to say. The following is a fair use extraction of a Deedat lecture under section 107.
By name, in the original scriptures, the Old Testament, according to Christian authorities, was preserved in the Hebrew language, and the New Testament in Greek scriptures, Greek language. In the Old Testament, in the Song of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 16, in the Hebrew language, it says, Hikko mamittakim vi kullo Muhammadim zehdudi vi zehrei bainat Jerusalem. Song of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 16. The word Muhammadim is Muhammadim.
Did you hear it? More importantly, did you catch it? Did you see the trick he used? He mispronounces Mahmad. The actual Hebrew word in Song of Solomon 5:16 is Mahmad. But once Deedat says Mohammedim, it's easy for him to then continue on with his argument based on the false information he has presented. That is to say, the name is Mohammedim. He has sold you his error, which really is his intentional deception. Because if he knew Hebrew, he would know that the word Mahmad is the right word. The problem is that Deedat has changed the text, and therefore he has corrupted the Word of God. What is the claim within all of the Mohammedan apologists in the world today? The Bible is corrupted. The Torah is corrupted. Who do we see corrupting it and changing the text to suit their own purpose? Men like Ahmed Deedat. So what does the Hebrew really say? The word is Mahmad, not Mohammedim. And what does Mahmad mean? It means delightful, an object of affection, it means beloved, it means goodly, it means lovely, it means pleasant, it means altogether lovely, and that's the way it is correctly translated. But Deedat is not done with his tricks.
You read it 1,000 times, altogether lovely, altogether lovely. Or let's say in another language, the praised one, Muhammad means the praised one.
Did you hear it? More importantly, did you catch it? Altogether lovely. He talks about it over and over. In another language means praised one. Well, actually, if I make up words, what he should have said was if I make up other words, because altogether lovely is English, and in another language, it's English to say praised one. Praised one does not mean altogether lovely. Praised one means somebody whose accomplishments, somebody whose attributes and characteristics deserve praise. A champion Olympian. It does not mean they are altogether lovely, that everything about them is physically beautiful and desirable. And then he continues with, Muhammad means praised one. So see, once he has substituted the words in the text of altogether lovely with praised one, just saying quickly, oh, in another language, that means praised one. I'm going to substitute the words I want to see in the Bible, praised one. then I can tell you that, well, Mohammed means praised one. See, you didn't see Mohammed because Mohammed means praised one, and the translators, they changed the name Mohammed. That's just wrong. Altogether lovely doesn't mean praised one. It doesn't mean that. Altogether lovely, if you read the context, Song of Solomon 5:16 is talking about the physical beauty, the physical attributes, the desirability of this woman's lover. So what did Deedat just do? Deedat, again, just changed the text. He just corrupted the Word of God. This is just unacceptable that any man who's supposed to be the smartest man in all of Mohammedism has to change the text of the Torah and the Psalms and the Bible, change the text to try and insert Mohammed's name. How ridiculous is that? And such drama. He uses such flair. You have no right to change his name. The problem is that the text does not use the phrase praised one or the name Mohammed. It does not say Mohammedim. It says Mahmad. And you can look at other verses in the Bible that use the same word Mahmad. And if you pronounce it properly, it doesn't jump out at you like Deedat twists the pronunciation to do. The text uses the word Mahmad. So what are Deedat's errors? He intentionally mispronounces the word Mahmad to make it sound like Mohammedim. And then he intentionally changes the text from altogether lovely to be praised one, because then he can try and claim, well, Mohammed means praised one. So what is Deedat doing wrong? Well, he is blinding himself with his desperation. He is desperate to find a mention of Mohammed in the Bible. And he twists the Word of God for Deedat's purposes and Deedat's meanings, not God's. Deedat has clearly not read the Bible, because what about the im? Well, Deuteronomy 10:17 calls God Elohe ha-Elohim, the God of gods. So Elohim means gods. It does mean plurality. It does not just mean plurality of respect. Deedat has clearly not studied the Bible, because Joshua 22:22 calls God Elohe ha-Elohim, the God of gods. Elohim means gods. Deedat clearly does not know the Bible, because Psalm 136:2 calls God Elohe ha-Elohim, the God of gods. Elohim means gods, plural. Regardless of what Deedat tries to claim, may the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.